Video games have always been the center of controversy. Due to their willingness to tackle taboo topics and graphic content, it seems people are always looking for things to blame on video games, even if it doesn't make any sense at all. Kind of like 20 hours a week gaming means you have a mental disorder. What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos. Welcome to Chaos Top 10s. Today, we're going to be going over 10 of the dumbest video game controversies of all time. Let's get started. This month's giveaway is for a new PlayStation 4 console. All you have to do to enter is drop a like on this video, be subscribed to the channel, and turn on your notifications so you never miss an upload. And in the comment section, let me know why you want to win the PS4 and include your Twitter handle so I can contact you if you're the winner. The winner will be announced at the end of the month. At number 10, we have Jack Thompson compares Bully to Columbine. I'm sure plenty of you know the infamous Jack Thompson, and if you don't know, he is a former U.S. lawyer who was one of the main anti-gamers in the mid to late 2000s, who filed hundreds of claims and lawsuits against game developers trying to get rid of gaming altogether. He was such a nuisance and his claims were so stupid that he actually was disbarred from the Supreme Court of Florida in 2008 for inappropriate conduct and making false statements. However, one of the dumbest things he ever did in his game-hating career was in 2005 when he attacked the game Bully and compared it to the Columbine Massacre, claiming that, like Klebold and Harrison Columbine, you become the ultimate bully. As many of you probably know, this is the exact opposite of what the game is about, as you play a kid trying to take down the bullies and stick up for the little guys on campus, but that didn't stop Thompson from attacking it time and time again, calling it school genocide. If you ever want a good laugh at how far some people will go to demonize video games, go check out Jack Thompson's Wikipedia page. It's pretty great. At number 9, zombie games encourage cannibalism. This is probably my favorite on this entire list due to how insanely ridiculous it actually is. Back in 2005, there was a game released called Stubbs the Zombie, Rebel Without a Pulse, where you played as a zombie running around and eating people's brains in comedic fashion. The game was pretty fun, and Stubbs the Zombie is a cult classic series, but in November of 2005, the game came under fire by U.S. Senator Joe Lieberman and David Walsh of the National Institute on Media and the Family, claiming that the game was cannibalistic and the worst kind of message to kids, and furthermore, it could harm the entirety of America's youth. I'm serious. These people thought a game where you ran around as a cartoon zombie would encourage kids to go actually eat each other's brains. Now, these claims were widely ridiculed by news outlets, and rightfully so. At number 8, we have Universal sues Nintendo over Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong was a huge hit when it first landed in the arcades in July of 1981, but Universal Studios, well, they weren't happy about it. You may be thinking, why would a movie studio be upset about a video game about a plumber and a monkey? Well, apparently Universal thought Donkey Kong was actually based on the movie King Kong, and they filed suit against Nintendo for trademark infringement in June of 1982, and they actually sent a cease and desist to Nintendo. But it was quickly revealed that Universal Studios didn't actually own the rights to King Kong, and the character was public domain. So not only was Nintendo not ripping anybody off, but Universal didn't even own the rights to the character that they were trying to sue for trademark infringement. Nintendo filed a countersuit against Universal, and they were awarded $1.8 million for legal fees. At number 7, we have PUBG sues Epic Games. This is a pretty recent development in the gaming world, and it's definitely one of the dumbest things to happen in recent years. Following the success of Fortnite Battle Royale, PUBG Corp, developers of the very popular PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds, decided to file suit against Fortnite developer Epic Games due to alleged copyright infringement. This is one of the most immature and childish lawsuits I think I've ever seen. Fortnite did not rip off any of the assets from PUBG, nor did it violate any copyright. The only thing that Fortnite used from PUBG is the Battle Royale concept, which doesn't even belong to PUBG in the first place. PUBG is not the first Battle Royale game, despite what the lawsuit is trying to make people believe. And even if they were the very first BR game, you can't claim ownership over something as broad as a gameplay mechanic. By that logic, Call of Duty can sue Battlefield for being a multiplayer shooter, and Team Fortress 2 can sue Overwatch for being a hero shooter. It just doesn't make sense. At number 6, we have Silicon Knights sues Epic Games. Man, Epic Games getting sued by everybody. Epic has been the target for a few stupid lawsuits over the years, and back in 2007, the Knights filed suit against Epic due to alleged developmental issues with their Unreal Engine, which they had licensed to use on their upcoming game called 2Human. According to Silicon Knights, Epic had not provided them with a working engine. They were forced to use their own funds to develop Gears of War instead of working on the engine. However, it was quickly revealed that Silicon Knights was lying about all of these things, and they were simply trying to stall development of Gears of War so they could eliminate the future competition. Epic Games then filed a countersuit against Silicon Knights for slander, breach of contract, and copyright infringement. In May of 2012, they won the lawsuit, which resulted in Silicon Knights having to pay them $10 million and recall and destroy all copies of their games that were developed using the Unreal Engine. Silicon Knights obviously went bankrupt and closed shortly after. Cracking into the top five today, how about Lindsay Lohan sues Rockstar? Rockstar has been the center of many controversies, some legitimate and some not, but this one was definitely one of the dumbest. Back when Grand Theft Auto first launched, it was a massive success, and I'm sure you guys saw the billboards that Rockstar put the blonde girl on in the bikini to promote the game. Well, actress Lindsay Lohan was upset. She thought it was her. She thought it was based off her likeness, and she filed suit against Rockstar for using her likeness without permission. However, Lohan didn't do her research because the girl on the billboards was actually modeled after Shelby Weilander, who is credited in the game itself. So Lohan's lawsuit was quickly thrown out. At number four, we have Left 4 Dead 2 and Hurricane Katrina. Left 4 Dead 2 is a fan-favorite zombie co-op shooter that was released in 2009 to critical acclaim, and it still has a massive following today thanks to the modding community. But when the game was released, it was the target of criticism from the Houston Chronicle attacked for being insensitive to the victims of Hurricane Katrina simply because part of the game took place in New Orleans. The game was also called racist by some because some of the zombies you shoot were African American, and Valve defended their game by saying the game was set in a fictionalized part of New Orleans and had nothing to do with Katrina, and there were many, many different races of zombies and there was no racism there. Are people really this desperate to be mad about something that they will attack a game simply for being set in a certain city, even if it had nothing to do with a natural disaster? At number three, we have a mother that blamed her son's suicide on EverQuest. This one's pretty upsetting. For those that don't know, EverQuest was an extremely popular and influential MMORPG released for the PC in 99. Think of World of Warcraft, just as big, okay? The game was good. It helped shape the way for other MMORPGs, and it was developed for years to come. But in November of 2001, a mother named Liz Woolley attacked the developers and claimed that her 21-year-old son had committed suicide due to his addiction to the game. She stated, "The further you get into it, the higher level you get, the longer you have to stay on it and move onward, and that isn't fun anymore. But then, you're addicted and you can't leave it." Now, I have no doubt that she was devastated at her son and what happened, but the whole situation, I don't know. It's just another example of someone trying to use video games as the scapegoat instead of maybe looking deeper and seeing if there were other problems. Lamar Alexander is the current senior U.S. Senator from Tennessee and has been in that position for over 15 years. He's definitely achieved some great things over that time, but in 2013, he said one of the dumbest things I've ever heard in my life, and it got him a ton of well-deserved heat. Lamar said, "You know, I think video games is a bigger problem than guns because video games affect people. But the First Amendment limits what we can do about video games." Yes, this U.S. senator said he thinks video games are a bigger problem than guns. And at number one, you guessed it, gaming disorders. That's right, the most recent gaming controversy. It's definitely the dumbest in my opinion. As of this year, June 18th, just the other day, gaming disorder is officially recognized as a real thing by the World Health Organization, meaning that if you're addicted to video games, you can now get the help you need and you'll have trained professionals to help you recover from your addiction. So what's the problem with this, you may ask? Aside from everything, I don't think I even need to explain. Is video game addiction a real thing? Yes, it is. But that's not the point. You can be addicted to any hobby in the world, be it video games, watching TV, reading, writing, cooking, your cell phone, you name it. It's not just video games that people start getting addicted to, but the World Health Organization wants you to think otherwise because they're trying to demonize gaming again. The biggest problem with this, in my opinion, is the fact that it opens the doors for tons and tons of other things to officially be recognized as disorders, I guess. The phrasing for gaming disorder is so broad that you could take the same logic and apply it to anything else and turn that into a disorder. Like, what's that? You like watching sports 10 hours a week? Well, you have a sports watching disorder. What's that? You have to go to the gym every day? Look out, you now have a gym disorder. That's the real problem with this new classification. It's way too broad, and it's obviously being driven by an agenda, not by actual science. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 of the dumbest video game controversies that we've seen so far. You guys, if you found this video informative, definitely drop a like and make sure you're subscribed. There's a playlist below if you want to check out all the other gaming top 10s. This one was a little more serious than we usually do, but I felt it was warranted. Let me know what you think about the number one spot, what your thoughts are on that in the comment section. I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you soon.